Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Róisín and the Forest Spirit. Chapter 1. The Enchanted Forest. Róisín had always felt a deep connection to the wilderness, but it was not until one crisp autumn morning that she stumbled upon the enchanted forest. Wrapped in a cloak the color of earth, she walked without a destination, her heart guiding her steps deeper into the untamed lands that stretched beyond her village. There was a whisper in the wind, a subtle call that beckoned her onwards, towards an ancient forest veiled in mist and legend. As she crossed the threshold, the air grew cooler, tinged with the scent of moss and wildflowers. The forest was alive, its trees towering giants that seemed to breathe, their leaves whispering secrets of a thousand years. Shafts of sunlight pierced the dense canopy, casting patterns of light and shadow that danced across the forest floor. Róisín paused, her senses attuned to the beauty that enveloped her. Drawn deeper into the heart of the forest, she found herself in a clearing dominated by an immense oak tree, its trunk wide and welcoming. It was known among the few who spoke of it as the heart of the wood, a sacred site where the veil between worlds was thin, where the spirits of nature were said to dwell. Here, under the ancient oak, Róisín first saw the forest spirit. He appeared gradually, his form coalescing from the verdant light that filtered through the leaves. His eyes were the deep green of the forest in shadow, his hair like strands of vines that intertwined with the air itself. The forest spirit looked at Róisín, and in his gaze, she felt an immediate and profound connection, as if he saw not just her, but into her past, her dreams, her intrinsic bond with the natural world. The spirit spoke, his voice the rustle of leaves and the rush of rivers. "Welcome, Róisín of the human realm. Long has it been since one of your kind has walked these paths with such clear intent. What brings you to the heart of the wood?" Róisín, initially taken aback, found her voice. "I came without purpose, drawn by a call I felt in the wind and in my soul. I am here, perhaps, to understand why." The spirit smiled, a gesture that seemed to make the entire clearing brighter. "The forest calls to those who bear the mark of the ancient pact, the bond between human and nature. Your heart has guided you to where the old magic still breathes." As they spoke, the forest around them seemed to lean in, listening. The spirit extended a hand, and from his touch sprouted a small flower, bright and blue as the sky on a clear day. "The forest recognizes you, Róisín, but to truly be one with it, you must be willing to face the trials set by the spirits of nature. Each trial is a step closer to us, a step deeper into the heart of the world." Moved by his words and the surreal beauty surrounding her, Róisín nodded. "I am ready. Tell me what I must do." "The trials will test your courage, your heart, and your bond with the earth," the spirit explained. "You will face challenges that may seem insurmountable, they are but reflections of your own fears and doubts. Overcome them, and you shall gain the blessings of the forest. The first trial, he revealed, would require her to venture into the Grotto of Whispers, a cavern hidden beneath the tangled roots of the heart of the wood. There, guarded by the guardian of the earth, a creature formed from the very soil and stone of the forest, lay the soil of the ancients. It was a sacred substance that held the essence of the forest's life force, and retrieving it would prove her resolve and respect for the natural world. Róisín readied herself to set forth on her journey, the words of the spirit resounding in her thoughts. She took another glance at the massive oak and could feel the ancient power pulsing through the atmosphere. She took a deep breath and moved ahead, her resolve unwavering and her heart calm. Chapter 2. The Trial of Earth. Roisin's journey led her deeper into the enchanted forest, where the air grew thick with the scent of earth and ancient growth. Her destination, the Grotto of Whispers, was said to be a place where the voices of the old world could still be heard, murmuring through the shadows and the stone. As she ventured on, the canopy above thickened, filtering the sunlight into mere shards that barely touched the forest floor. The entrance to the grotto was hidden beneath the knotted roots of the heart of the wood, its opening almost indistinguishable from the rest of the forest floor. It took Róisín a moment to discern the subtle signs, a configuration of stones that seemed intentional, and a cooler draft of air that brushed against her face, carrying the faint, musty aroma of damp earth. Descending into the grotto, Róisín found herself in a vast underground chamber, its walls alive with luminescent fungi that cast a soft, ethereal glow. The air was cool and moist, filled with the sounds of dripping water and the soft rustle of small creatures scurrying in the dark. The path before her was paved with smooth stones, worn down by the passage of time and countless unseen feet. As she walked, the whispers began. They were soft at first, indistinct, as if the shadows themselves were speaking in tongues long forgotten by the world above. But as Róisín moved deeper into the grotto, the whispers grew louder, more insistent. They spoke of ancient times, of battles fought and alliances forged, of the deep, unbreakable bonds between the spirits of the earth and the stewards of the land. At the heart of the Grotto of Whispers stood the guardian of the earth, a colossal figure carved from stone and covered in patches of moss and lichen. Its eyes, made of deep, dark emeralds, shone with an inner light that seemed to pierce through Róisín. The guardian was both awe-inspiring and intimidating, a protector of the sacred soil of the ancients, which lay in a pile at its feet, glowing faintly under the light of the fungi. The guardian's voice was like the rumble of the earth itself as it spoke. "Róisín, seeker of the forest's heart, why do you disturb the slumber of the earth?" With courage bolstered by her quest, Róisín replied, "I come for the soil of the ancients, to prove my worth and forge a deeper bond with the forest. I seek the blessing of the earth." "A noble quest," the guardian mused, its voice echoing off the stone walls. "But the soil is not given lightly. You must prove your strength and your respect for the earth. Only then can you carry away its essence." The trial was set. Róisín was to navigate a series of challenges designed by the guardian to test her physical strength, her endurance, and her wisdom. The first challenge was a physical one. She had to move 3 heavy boulders, each engraved with ancient symbols, from one side of the chamber to the other, arranging them according to the symbols that matched the constellations painted on the cavern ceiling. With effort and determination, Róisín pushed and rolled the massive stones across the rough cavern floor. Her muscles ached, and her breath came in short gasps, but she persisted, driven by the knowledge that each push brought her closer to her goal. The next challenge tested her endurance. The guardian led her through a series of underground tunnels, each more twisting and complex than the last. The paths were narrow and often steep, and the air grew thinner as they descended. Róisín followed closely, her lamp casting long shadows on the walls. She focused on her breathing, on the steady beat of her heart, and on the feel of the earth beneath her feet, drawing strength from its steady presence. Finally, the wisdom challenge required Róisín to solve a riddle that the guardian posed, a riddle that spoke of the cycles of life and the balance of nature. She listened carefully, her mind weaving together the clues embedded in the ancient words. With a deep understanding of the natural order and a whisper of intuition, she gave her answer, which pleased the guardian. Impressed by her display of strength, endurance, and wisdom, the guardian stepped aside, allowing Róisín access to the soil of the ancients. "You have proven your worth, Róisín. Take this soil, and with it, the strength and blessing of the earth." Róisín approached the glowing soil with reverence. She scooped it into a pouch made of woven leaves, feeling its warmth seep into her palms. It was more than just earth. It was a symbol of her connection to the forest and its ancient magic. With the soil secured, Róisín made her way back through the Grotto of Whispers. The voices of the past seemed to approve, their whispers now gentle and encouraging. As she ascended from the depths of the earth, she felt changed, not just by the physical exertion, but by a deeper, more profound bond with the world around her. Emerging into the twilight of the forest clearing, Róisín took a deep breath of the fresh, evening air. She looked back at the entrance to the grotto, now just a dark slit in the earth, and smiled. The first trial was complete, but her journey was far from over. With the blessing of the earth now hers, she was ready to face the next trial, the trial of water, with renewed vigor and a heart full of anticipation for the wonders and challenges that lay ahead. Chapter 3, The Trial of Water. Having conquered the trial of earth, Róisín now faced the trial of water, a test of purity and clarity of heart. The next morning, she ventured towards the Lake of Mirrors, a mystical body of water known for its reflective surface that not only mirrored the physical form, but also revealed the true essence of those who gazed upon it. Legend had it that the lake was as old as time itself. Filled by the tears of the moon goddess when she mourned the passing of the sun at dusk. As Róisín approached the lake, the forest opened to reveal a vast expanse of still water, its surface smooth and undisturbed, mirroring the sky above. The tranquility of the lake was palpable, and Róisín paused at its edge, taking a moment to admire its serene beauty. She knelt down at the water's edge, her reflection gazing back at her, unblemished and clear. The water sprites, guardians of the lake, emerged from the water as misty figures, their forms fluid and ever-changing. They surrounded Róisín, their presence cool and damp, and spoke in harmonious voices. "Welcome, seeker of the forest's heart. To prove your worth to the spirit of water, you must retrieve the midnight dew, collected only under the light of a full moon." Róisín nodded in understanding, her heart calm despite the daunting task ahead. The sprites continued, "But be warned, the lake reflects not just your form, but your soul. Only those with hearts unburdened by deceit can succeed in this trial." As night approached, Róisín prepared herself, sitting quietly by the lake's edge. She emptied her mind of all thoughts, focusing only on the gentle lap of water against the shore and the soft rustle of the night breeze through the trees. As the moon rose, casting a silver glow across the world, the surface of the lake began to shimmer with a light of its own. The midnight dew started to form, tiny droplets of silver that glittered on the surface of the lake. Róisín reached out with a small glass vial, an item given to her by the sprites, designed to collect the dew without disturbing the water's surface. With a steady hand and a pure heart, she carefully gathered the dew, drop by drop, her movements respectful and measured. Suddenly, the serpents of water rose from the depths of the lake, their bodies sleek and powerful, encircling Róisín. Their eyes glowed with a light that matched the moon's, and they moved with a grace that was both beautiful and intimidating. Róisín remained calm, her heart steady, meeting their gaze with a sincerity that spoke of her genuine intentions. The serpents, sensing the purity of her heart, began to swirl around her in a dance of water and light, their movements becoming a part of the lake's chorus of reflections. Slowly, they retreated back into the depths, leaving Róisín to her task, now with a sense of approval from the lake's guardians. With the vial now full, Róisín sealed it carefully, ensuring that the midnight dew remained untouched by any but the moon's light. She stood, holding the vial up to the moon, and it glowed with a luminescence that confirmed its sacred nature. The trial was complete, but her success was not merely about collecting the dew. It was a testament to the clarity and truth of her spirit. Feeling a profound connection to the water, Róisín whispered her thanks to the lake and its guardians. Her journey back through the forest was quiet, the knowledge of having passed another trial giving her a deep sense of peace. The forest seemed to acknowledge her success, the trees whispering more loudly now, as if in celebration. As she emerged from the forest, the first light of dawn was breaking over the horizon. The night's challenges had deepened her resolve, and she felt ready to face whatever the next trial might bring. With the earth and water trials behind her, Róisín's connection to the natural elements had grown stronger, each step forward on her path not just a test, but a profound communion with the world around her. Her heart lighter and her purpose clear, Róisín prepared to face the final trial, the trial that would, if she succeeded, unite her forever with the forest spirit. With the blessings of earth and water, her journey was shaping her, molding her into a guardian of the forest, a role she was born to fulfill. The path ahead was daunting, yet filled with the promise of revelation and the completion of her union with the enchanted world she had grown to love. Chapter 4, The Final Blessing. trials of earth and water behind her, Róisín approached the culmination of her quest with a heart full of anticipation. The dawn greeted her as she returned to the heart of the wood, the sacred grove where her journey had begun. The forest seemed to recognize her transformation, the trees whispering, and the winds humming a welcome as she walked the familiar path to the ancient oak. As she reached the clearing, the early morning light filtered through the branches, casting golden beams onto the forest floor. The earth elders and water sprites were already gathered, their forms more distinct in the morning light, shimmering with the essence of their respective elements. They formed a semicircle around the forest spirit, who awaited Roisin's arrival with a serene expression. The forest spirit stepped forward as she approached, his voice echoing softly in the cool air. "Róisín, you have navigated the challenges set before you with courage and purity of heart. You have earned the soil of the ancients and captured the midnight dew, proving your bond with earth and water. Now, it is time for you to receive the final blessing." Róisín bowed her head in respect, her hands clutching the pouch of soil and the vial of dew. She felt a deep connection to these elements, their powers intertwining within her, each trial having woven them more tightly into the fabric of her being. To complete your union with the forest and its spirit, these elements must become a part of you, just as you will become a part of the forest. He took the pouch and the vial from her, pouring the soil into his left hand and holding the vial in his right. With a gesture of summoning, he called upon the essence of the air and fire, the only elements not yet represented in her trials. A gentle breeze kicked up, swirling around them, and a small flame appeared above his palm, dancing above the soil without burning it. "These are the elements of life, earth, water, air, and fire," the forest spirit explained. "Together, they create balance and harmony. Today, they will bind you to the forest and its magic." He mixed the soil and the dew together, the mixture bubbling slightly as the elements combined. Then, he used the air to cool it and the fire to meld them into a single, radiant crystal. The crystal pulsed with a soft light, its colors changing as it absorbed the properties of each element. The forest spirit took Rosine's hand, placing the crystal over her heart. "With this crystal, you accept the guardianship of the forest. May it guide you and protect you as you have pledged to protect it." As the crystal touched her skin, it dissolved into a cascade of light, sinking into her body and filling her with a warm glow. Róisín felt her senses heighten, her awareness extending beyond the physical, into the very essence of the forest around her. She could feel the life in every leaf and twig, the flow of the streams, and the whisper of the winds. The transformation was profound. Roisin's eyes opened, and they shone with a luminescence that mirrored the forest itself. She looked around at the gathered spirits, seeing not just their forms, but understanding their essence. The earth elders nodded in approval, their rocky features breaking into slow smiles. The water sprites danced around her, their laughter like the sound of rain on leaves. The air and fire spirits, less visible but equally present, flickered around her, their forms briefly flaring in acknowledgement. "You are now one of us," the forest spirit declared, his voice resonant with joy. "One with the forest and its ancient magic. Together, We will guard this place, protect its secrets, and ensure its legacy. The spirits of nature gathered closer, their energies mingling in a celebratory dance. The forest came alive with sound and color, a symphony of life and magic that resonated through its depths. Róisín stood at the center, a conduit of this harmony, her heart beating in unison with the ancient rhythms of the earth. As the celebration subsided, the forest spirit approached Róisín once more. Your journey has changed you, Róisín. You came to us a seeker, and now you stand as a guardian. Remember, the trials may be over, but your duty to the forest and its spirit begins now. Róisín nodded, a sense of purpose filling her. I understand, and I am ready. I will protect the forest as it has protected me, with all my strength and all my heart. The forest spirit smiled, pleased with her resolve. Go now, Róisín, and explore your new realm. Learn its paths and its secrets. Be its protector and its friend. And know that you are never alone, for the spirit of the forest is with you, always. With those final words, Róisín took her first steps into the forest, her senses attuned to its magic. She felt every breath of wind, every rustle of leaf, and knew that she was home. The forest was part of her now, and she was part of it, bound together by the deepest magic, ready to face whatever the future might bring.